everyone. So good day, everyone. Mabuhay mga kapamana. Mabuhay JKI members. Yes, isang masigabong palakpakan naman dyan. Okay, great. So welcome to the 2023 GKA membership meeting. It's just astonishing to see how all people from all walks of life are all gathered here for their love and advocacy towards cultural heritage. Yay! If you're all here, people on site and online, do give yourself a pat on your back because you made time today, diba? I know you are all busy here, pero you made time. Yeah. So again, thank you everyone for coming here today. Okay, before we begin our meeting, can I ask where everyone is coming from? People online and on site? Okay, can I hear or can I see people coming from, let's say, Metro Manila? A raise of hand? Ah, okay, majority are in Metro Manila. How about in Northern Luzon, like Ilocos? Ooh, interesting. So a few people. How about people online? How about Southern Luzon? Southern Luzon, like Batangas and all. Ooh, medyo madami din. Interesting. Meron bang from Visayas? Do we have people from Visayas? Okay. Okay, how about Mindanao? Okay. How about people online? Can we get from the tech team? Where are the majority coming from? Yeah, baka meron pang umaabot ng Mindanao and Visayas. Very, very great that we are spread out all over the country. It just shows that people are really protecting or interested in our cultural heritage. So siguro I heard, so we have here from, Ikaw, Davao, Bataan, Ilocos Norte. Ooh, and we have a lot participant online. Nice, nice to see it. So everyone on site, kindly wave or we can all greet people on site as well. Hello, everyone. Hello. Okay. Now, to officially start, our theme for this year's membership meeting is Renaissance. Renaissance is synonymous to rebirth, revival, and reinvigoration. Surely our culture has undergone different changes, different processes as we go along time. As a result, we keep learning and rediscovering our heritage. At the same time, or alongside it, ourselves. Now, to give more discussion and to give more idea of this spirit of Renaissance, may I call on Mr. Lito Ligon, our chairman of the board, to give his opening remarks. A warm applause, everyone.
Thank you, Christine. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Lito Ligon, Ms. Mita Rufino, Architect Manolo Noche, and the rest of the board of Grupo Kalinangan, and the members. Welcome to Grupo Kalinangan Incorporated, and I hope that you will enjoy your afternoon with us, as we learn from our activities and our achievements. Now, just to explain myself is just to go around brief history, why I like heritage and why I like history. It goes way back from the time I was a kid because my parents would always influence me on the history and heritage of our archipelago, why I love the country. Now, through the years, I've learned from books that my father would give me, and I would read them always, especially coffee table books of heritage and history. Then, eventually, by the time of 2007, internet was starting, basically. Then I noticed not too many sites have been shown already, not too many heritage sites have been shown in the internet. So I told myself that will be my advocacy, to take pictures and to inform people the beauty of our country. And so by 2-3 years ago, Joel invited me to join this. And I gladly accepted it because in Grupo Carina, in GKI, there is what we call the cultural mapping, wherein they go from town to town and make an inventory of all the heritage structures and the history of the town, of the particular, even of a small town that's not really of heritage. What we think is not of heritage, we find out there is also. And there's also the volunteer engagement committee wherein we go around, tour around and see what's important of particular sites. So my thoughts is always to search, to look, and to learn from what we see. Because like with me, I would go search of historical sites, search of good food, good Filipino food in the festivals, and even for the artistry of the works that we do, the textiles, the products, like even bazaars I would join. I would go and see, like Miss Rufino's Artefino is one of them, and I would see the creativity of the Filipino spirit. So that's what's important to me, because I would always say, I buy local, I support local. That's more important now. So in ending my message to you, please help us preserve heritage and look at the value of what we have here in this country, and to search, to look, and to learn from it all. Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Lito. So everyone has their own story. Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your story about your journey for being one of the cultural advocate here in the Philippines. Okay, so Grupo Kalinangan is an organization that has achieved momentous achievement in the past. And we continuously strive and advance because our passion and love once again for culture, as well as the efforts to innovate methods for cultural preservation, relentless call for dialogue and cultural exchange. With this, I would like to call Architect Manolo Noche, the president of Grupong Kalinangan, to discuss the 2022 organizational report. Sir Manolo?
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everyone. Everyone in championing heritage and culture in our country. Welcome to GKI for our new members, our old members, our members here physically live in the National Museum of the Arts, and for our members who are online. I would like to present to you the 2022 report of what GKI undertook during the past calendar year or the past organizational year. GKI, as you may know, or for those of you who are new to the organization, is an organization that is committed in promoting, preserving, enhancing, and assisting in the promotion of culture and heritage in this country. We do so by undertaking training of people who are interested in their cultures within their communities through training of cultural mapping. Then we assist as well and engage with LGUs all around the country in providing them assistance in undertaking cultural mapping platforms for their compliance with the NCCA PRECOP of heritage and tangible and intangible heritage within their communities, which is of course a mark as well of any LGU to be able to submit to government for their mark of good governance. Sadly, in the Philippines, a good number of our municipalities and even cities, for that matter, are non-compliant And cultural mapping now is becoming a very important tool, not only in identifying what we have as a country or as a community, but as well as utilizing that tool to promote, so that at the end, our culture lingers and our culture continues to grow and develop. Lalo na ngayon po na ang Pilipinas ay masyado nang immersed sa mga bagong, makabagong influensya at kultura na nanggagaling sa ibang bansa. Kailangan natin ipatatag ang ating sariling kultura dahil ang ating kultura ay mayaman. Kailangan lang natin yan i-promote and popularize as well. And that is what basically GKI is doing. Now, on the lighter side, GKI is also an organization that helps promote culture through a lot of informal platforms, from tours to Bayong sessions and what have you. Of course, this is one way or the other affected by the lingering pandemic that we have experienced throughout the world, resulting now in our engagement and our contact with our people, with our members, to be restricted in an online platform. And you know naman quite well how that has become effective, if ever that is the case, maybe. So we are fortunate enough that we were allowed to host already physically. We've done this as well last year as a trial when the country opened up, started opening up. But this year, we were talking as a board that we should come out with a bang and therefore reinvent ourselves, not simply because we are as an organization that's 7 years old, but we need to reinvigorate ourselves. And that is why we call this particular meeting of ours a renaissance, which is a rebirth and a revitalization of what is familiar, and what that familiarity is our shared culture and heritage. So, okay, it's our 2022 organizational report, and I am your president for this period. I'm Architect Manolo Maximo Lopez del Castillo Noche. I am a faculty as well of the University of Santo Tomas College of Architecture. I've been there for the past 34 years. I don't know why I'm still there, but I'm still there. And I've been at Heritage for the longest time, part of the faculty as my commitment as a researcher with them. And at the same time, like our chairman, Lito Ligon, I was inculcated and I embraced culture at a very, very young age when my mother would tag me along to all of her trips. We used to have what you call vacacion grande and vacacion chico, and we would always go out around the country. When traveling around the country in the 60s and 70s was not as convenient as it is today. And that really opened my eyes and eventually my heart. And as I grow older, my mind and my memory of all the things that I've seen around this beautiful country of ours that sadly has changed because time is very fast creeping on us. So without further ado, our progress report for this particular calendar year. First, we have webinars, Utilizing Cultural Heritage for Tourism Recovery, held in partnership with the Association with Tourism Officers of the Philippines. It's a whole day webinar focused on identifying stakeholders in cultural heritage and recommendations of local cultural assets to be used for tourism development. Members of LGU's tourism officers and staff, members of local culture and art councils, heritage advocates and practitioners were the target audience for this day. So this particular webinar that we conducted, we targeted the tourism people because, of course, at the end of the day, once culture has been mapped, what do you do with it? So the best way for you to use this is, of course, twofold. One is education, and the other one is tourism. And we know quite well that in times of peace, and hopefully we are still in a long period of peace, tourism is a very major component in economic recovery and development, and as well as nation building. Next slide. Then we also do cultural mapping training program, batch 12. GKI, as I mentioned, its main focus as an organization is to assist people who are interested in culture and heritage to map their communities. Of course, the reality is you do have a lot of members or you do have a lot of participants who do so for other reasons or for, shall we say, compliance reasons. But nevertheless, if we do get individuals who participate for either compliance or for either love of passion, we do hope that when they go home, they're able to utilize this and helping their communities through mapping of their inventory. So we've done that for 12 batches already. The biggest batch to have graduated from the program so far is batch 12. 49 members, mostly from Mahataw, Batanes, from the north to Malang in Cotabato from the south, participated. So if you're familiar, we're talking now about north to south of the Philippines participating in our cultural mapping, aimed at creating an awareness and appreciation of the benefits of cultural heritage conservation and cultural mapping process. And this training included 14 CPD credit units for architecture and 15 units on environmental planning. This was done as a hybrid of face-to-face as well as online, with a good number of them coming all the way to Manila to participate in the face-to-face, especially during the yung immersion tour na ginawa namin, courtesy of the city of Taguig. Yan. A lot of people are not aware that Taguig is a historic town and that has a historic core, and that's not BGC. Okay? So, it's for a lot of people, they've realized that all of a sudden, ito pala ang Taguig. Katabi ng lawa. And they have this very wonderful, they're trying to clean it, river that they would promote as a sort of like a tour, cruise kind of thing. You know, those are the little things that a lot of people don't realize. When we look at culture and heritage, especially heritage sites, we view it always as postcard pictures. But no, everything starts with the raw. Everything starts with the rough. And it just requires vision from people because they know there is potential, because they have already done their mapping, and they know that there is a product. And then it's just later on saying to LGU, to Mayor, etong lawa natin. O, anong makikita sa lawa dyan? Puros basura yan eh. Yeah, Mayor, pero you know what do I see? I see fields of green, red roses too. It's a beautiful world. And then before you know it, mabenta mo na yan. And then here you come, the tourists are coming. Diba? Alam nyo naman ang mga turista, they don't want to be educated. They just want to have a good time. And all you have to do is clean and show na may lumang bahay, nakabarot saya yung host, inaapi yung muchacha, hinahagis sa hagdan, diba? Parang pelikula, diba? And then lahat naman kayo nanonood, ang galing ng arte, parang si Etang Dicher. Hindi nyo nakilala kung si Etang Dicher is, di ba? And then papakain na kayo ng buffet, luto nila, di ba? And that's what culture is. Okay, next. Third, we have ALAB, GKI's General Membership Meeting of 2022. GKI members and partners assembled in Holiday Inn Makati last 26th of March, 2022, almost a year ago. For our annual general membership meeting, which we themed ALAB. Accomplishments and upcoming activities for GKI were presented to those present that day, and a new set of trustees were elected during the biennial election held on that day as well. I was unfortunately one of those who was elected. Next. Kapamana Exploration, Malabon Heritage Walking Tour. Members of GKI and several guests trekked to the town of Malabon de Tambobong in Metro Manila last 30 April 2022. And this was spearheaded by our trustee, architect Richard Tuason Sanchez Bautista. Can you stand up, please, Richard, so that you can be heard? Richard is a hallmark in preserving and promoting the very, historic and rich, culturally rich history of Malabon de Tambobong, or better known today simply as Malabon, in Manila, what used to be the fish capital of the Philippines. Yan. And they visited numerous historic sites in the town, from the San Bartolome Church in the town center, the historic heritage homes. Malabon is a very rich town. A lot of people don't realize that. There are a lot of old mansions there, and a lot of people still cling to their past. Their society is so rich and closed that they preserve whatever is there. And they went to historic, unrecognized historic spots. Very important word, unrecognized. It is our responsibility as the purveyors of history and heritage and culture to identify what is not popular. Yung popular, hindi na natin kailangan identify yan eh. Gasgas na yan eh. Sawa na ang tao dyan eh. Pero those that you do not, people do not know. Sometimes these are sa likod ng bahay. May lumang balon dyan. Minsan, bakod na lang natitira, pero ang yaman pala ng history doon. These are all part and parcel of our legacy. Kaya I always tell LGUs whenever I travel around the Philippines, huwag niyong sabihin sa akin wala kayong kultura. Huwag niyong sabihin sa akin wala kayong heritage. Hindi niyo lang alam. Hindi lang ninyo alam. Simply because probably, kayong mismo na sa LGU, baka dayo kayo. In short, you're not really from there from the very beginning. And that's the reason why you don't know what the culture is. But ask around. You would then find out it's so rich, especially when you talk to the elders in that community, you will find out a lot of hidden secrets. So we went to historic homes, public market, and even tasted some culinary dishes distinctly from Malabon. And we're not talking about pancit. So they have more than just pancit Malabon to promote that is uniquely theirs. Ano ba tawag mo doon, Richard? Yung parang triangulo na sinasabi nyo? O yun, sa triangle, diba na... So yon, diba yung pagkain mismo, yung pagluto, the ingredient that is used, that's what makes it different. As you transpose ideas coming from areas, like I keep telling a lot of people, okay, pancit Malabon may have started in Malabon, but you transplanted it, say, sabihin na natin, in Lucena. But then, nag-iba na ang sangkap to a certain extent. Pancit de Lucena na yan, hindi na yung Malabon. Nag-iiba. So that's the start of culinary culture along the way because of the uniqueness of how it is prepared, the ingredients that was prepared, even sabihin na natin, yung tubig na ginamit kasi ibang uri ang tubig from point to point. Okay, next. Then we have number 5, Kapamana Tour, Linang Indang, a hyper-local gastronomy tour. Conducted last July 2, the GKI members and other guests trooped to the town of Indang in Cavite to fill their minds and stomachs. Participants were able to go to the public market or what they called Baraka, the Municipio San Gregorio Magno Church in Indang, Cavite. One of the more, shall we say, well, how do I describe it? Well, it's intact, but again, medyo pinaglalaruan ng Cura Paroco, yung building, no, kung ano-ano pinagdadagdag. As I always term it, binabakla. But this is where we come in by identifying ano ba talaga ang cultural heritage? Bakit dinadagdagan? Simply just because mukhang maganda lalo eh pag dinagdagan. Nawawala yung cultural heritage. Nawawala yung kanyang reason, yung historical value when you start adding. But nevertheless, that's still part and parcel of the history of the town of Indang. Members of the Mahabang Kahoy Weavers Cooperative were able to show the participants their looming traditions and textile weaves. A lot of people didn't know that Indang has a rich textile historical heritage. No? And sometimes these are the things that nanawawala na. Yung traditional weaving. Like I myself, my father comes from the town, the historic town of Taal in Batangas. And when I used to go there as a child, when you start entering the town itself, you have all of these stretchers, bamboo stretchers with husi stretched for miles around. And then you have all the grand ladies who are embroidering. Ngayon, wala na yon. So these are long lost traditions that hopefully we could still map. And then through miracle of fate, you know, revive. Okay? It's difficult to revive when you cannot map it anymore. And that's the reason and the beauty of mapping. While it's still there, while it's still living, it needs to be protected. Members of the National Coffee Research Center showed coffee making and gave samples better than Starbucks. And a great lunch was served at Sanctuario Farm showing farming life. Oh, by the way, we also have great lunch later on. So please do stay. And when we start mingling with one another and socializing and networking, do so with our sumptuous buffet that we prepared for those of you who are here. For those of you online, your sumptuous buffet is in your refrigerator. So please avail of whatever you have in your fridge. Next, please. Then we also have our accreditation with the National Commission for the Culture and the Arts. This was released in the 5th of July. We became an accredited civil society organization by NCCA. We always renew our membership with the accrediting agency. So we are a legitimate organization. We are not a fly-by-night group. So we have accreditation from NCCA. With this certification, GKI was not only recognized as a formidable organization, but the eligibility for future grant projects. Okay, and when we do get grant projects, we do need assistance as well. Because at the end of the day, we will implement a project. And that's where the membership base comes in. So those of you who are now active members or now new members, please, the call of action of Renaissance is involvement. We want you to be involved. And not simply because you are joining so that you could collect certificates that you're members of organizations. Next. Now, we also participated during the 9th General Assembly of the Local Historical Committee Network. GK has been a member of the LHCN since 2016 and is a trusted member of the National Historical Commission of the Philippines. This particular assembly was conducted in Cebu City, and I basically represented GKI during this particular meeting. And in Cebu, the General Assembly ratified and finalized the proposed National Action Plan for Local Historical Development for 2022 to 2027. The next LHCN meeting will be conducted in Mindanao. If I'm not mistaken, they're now looking at either Cagayan de Oro City or Zamboanga, I think is that what they're looking at. So it's either Cagayan de Mesamis or Zamboanga City. Next. We also conduct our Kapamana Heritage Exploration in Pampanga. So with the active participation of our members, we do conduct tours within host communities. Again, this is where members' activity and participation is crucial because you will then help as well identify areas that are very interesting for people to visit. On the 27th of August, 2022, GKI members and guests trooped to the province of Pampanga for a tour organized by Mr. Gilbert Gungon, who is a member of GKI. Places visited were the Bacalor Dike for a morning on historical talk of the province, the Church of San Guillermo, San Fernando train station, the Museo Ning Angeles, the Pamintuan Mansion, and the sunset, romantic sunset at the Echo Park. Lunch was in a restaurant called Balye Kapampangan, where a gastronomic Kapampangan fair treated the hungry bellies of those who attended. And then to top it all off, there was a Kalesa ride along the San Fernando Road, and a Kapampangan alphabet and talk was taught to the members. So again, even language is something that we need to promote because that defines a culture and history of a society. Okay, next. Though, of course, we are all united by a common mother tongue, and that is Filipino, which is, of course, Tagalog in its base, mother base. But we have to remember as well that the Philippines is a multi-dialectic society and that we have to respect and learn and understand all of these languages. Bayong sessions, three Bayong sessions were conducted last year. On February 26th, a Bayong session led by Mr. Rome Candanza, a trustee. He's here. Rome, can you stand up? And he discussed the cool facts and anecdotes on the provinces of Bicol. But though Rome is from Albay, but his home base is in Camsur, Camarines Sur. On the 14th of May, 2022, Chef Alan Luis Gizon, member led the session with a talk on biscuit, galletas, cookies, at iba pa. And on the 23rd of July, 2022, Mr. Lito Ligon, our chairman, conducted a virtual tour of everybody's rich historical town, the town of Bagak, as according to Señor Acuzar in his Las Casas de Acuzar, the notorious transplanted town in Bagak. Okay, I would leave it up to you as to your interpretation of what this resort town is all about. If this is considered heritage promotion or what, it is open to everybody's own interpretation and translation. But nevertheless, it was interesting to share what this community is because it contains a lot of the, shall we say, looted mansions from the Philippines transplanted to another town. Okay? Next. Leadership course for cultural heritage towards in challenging circumstances. Now, not only do we enjoin members to become active and participants, but to participate, but we also promote members to attend sponsored seminars locally and so more so internationally. In October of 2022, our trustee and finance head, Mr. Joel Aldor, was invited to a leadership course for cultural heritage stewards in challenging circumstances in Den Haag, in the Kingdom of the Netherlands, a six-day course to build various leadership capacities through technical lectures, skills, workshops, and collaborative activities. The formal launch of the Cultural Emergency Response as an independent organization, GKI has been partnering with this since 2018 for projects for cultural heritage in crises. So when we talk about cultural heritage, we know quite well that majority of them are in deep crises. They need to be identified, what is the nature of the crises and how we can help promote and protect. Crises may not necessarily be because of war. Crises may be in the form of infiltration from outside culture that can destroy and literally saturate what we have because ito na ang nagiging popular, lalo na sa mga kabataan. Soon, as I always say to my students in UST, is that the Philippines might become a South-South Korea because of the infiltration of all of the K-pop influences. And then we forget our own, and all of a sudden, our idols are all Koreans. So we need to build that because that is crisis as well in how we can protect what is ours, but at the same time, embracing what is foreign to a certain extent. We don't shut ourselves. We're not a hermit kingdom. But at the same time, we're not literally just a sponge that accepts everything and dilutes what is traditionally ours. Next. We had our partnership with the City of Pasig, Pasig Cultural Mapping, Phase 1, and the Pasig Memorial Portal. On July of 2022, the initial phase of the Pasig cultural mapping was included with a list of identified cultural properties and a local cultural profile of the city of Pasig. The project phase included training, surveying, field work, and validation with stakeholders with the use of the mobile heritage online, or what we call MOHON. On 26 August The Memoria Portal by PASIG, LGU, and GKI was launched as a platform for cultural mapping. It is a very interesting application, the Memoria, because it is a crowdsourcing portal where members can share their photos and stories of PASIG. So the community at large, all they have to do is log on to Memoria in PASIG, and they could now upload all the pictures they have as they are growing up in the city of PASIG and put anecdotes. And that then becomes a collective photo album of the city of PASIG. So, of course, you know, a lot of people now are sending their more relevant, or shall we say, more recent photos. But yes, that's still relevant simply because in the next 20, 30, 40 years, that's heritage as well. But a good number of them are starting to look at their Lola's Baul and bringing out all of the dusty photo albums and starting to scan and upload all of these pictures. And before you know it, you have now a clearer picture of what diverse communities in PASIG share or tell. And importante yon, because it tells us who the Pasigueños are then, now, and hopefully in the future. Okay, next. Memorandum signing between the City of PASIG and the United Nations Development Program, Philippines, UNDP. A memorandum of agreement between the PASIG City Government and UNDP Philippines to commit and collaborate continuously in promoting cultural heritage. That's the good thing about our very stalwart mayor in PASIG, Vico Soto. He's very much a champion of PASIG history and heritage. Being the president, represented, of course, GKI, and I signed for this particular memorandum. Okay, next. Okay, our cultural mapping activities we've conducted last year, Milagros. Milagros is a town in the main island of Masbate. We provided technical assistance to the municipal government of Milagros in conducting cultural mapping and establishing a local cultural inventory, the first in the whole island province of Masbate. GKI's project team accomplished a local cultural profile and set the form submitted to the NCCA, Philippine Registry of Cultural Property Office. With this, the town was able to earn their much needed and much deserved certificate of compliance with the NCCA. With submitting this compliance, they will now get a good mark with the DILG, and that is now one of the forefronts for the release of a particular budget that the municipality will be able to utilize. So kailangan yung cultural mapping na yan. Okay, next. We did as well a roadshow in the province of Sorsogon, headed by Mr. Rome Candanza, our VP Officer for Cultural Mapping Partnership. He led a mini roadshow for selected municipalities in the province last December. GKI aims is to present consulting and professional services for cultural mapping and heritage development. There were several municipalities who have a big amount of cultural assets in their towns. All of them await to be documented. Again, as I said, the need for cultural mapping is so great. The number of people undertaking mapping is so small, we call for participation from our members to help us achieve this goal of eventually mapping majority of the communities around the country. Next. Okay, our annual report. If you want to check your emails to view the complete document, they are uploadable. And you could please, this is all top secret for our members only. Thou shalt not share this to competing organizations. Next. Okay, do I still have anything to share? Lana? Okay, so that basically ends our report for 2022. 2023 has started with a bang. We are now conducting a cultural mapping in the town of Torrijos in the island province of Marinduque. We've been there for the past month. Three of our active members are there helping and documenting everything that they can find in that little town. And we are as well in discussions with other communities. Outside of that, we are also in discussions with AIM for Asian Institute of Management for a collaboration with training of our cultural mappers. Outside of that are the social engagements that we will continue, shall we say, in terms of the Bayong sessions, if there are interested topics you may want to think about. In our Bayong sessions, mind you, no subject is taboo. As long as you're interested in a subject matter and there is heritage component to it, remember, everything and anything that is human in activity is a heritage cultural manifestation. Not that because we are overtly religious do we prevent certain topics from being discussed. No. We would like to share opinions and our members to contribute their stories with us. That's the only thing we could, that's the only way we could learn. How do we understand cross-provincial boundaries if we don't share your opinions to the rest of the organizations? So again, as I said, my mantra is involvement. Renaissance is not just a reflection. Renaissance is basically a progression, a rebirth, and more so, a call of action through involvement of our members. So with that, I thank you, and I end my talk regarding 2022's report. Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Manolo. Okay, so I understand, that we are still, I like what Sir Manolo said, that we are still discovering some. We might not know that this is actually a part of our heritage unless we start to tell our story. No, and as long as we keep on reliving it, we can map it. It is a start of something. Okay, so for the next part is the discussion of the exciting activity for this year. But before I call Sir Lito in the stage, can I ask the members here, what are they looking forward to this year? As some of us are just new, some are here for a long time. So what do you think or what are you looking forward to this year? So anyone who would like to share, maybe they can give us their name, where they're from, and what are you looking forward to being a member of the GKI this year? Okay, so I would like to call the first people, the early bird here, ma'am. May we know who you are and what are you looking forward to this year?
Hi, I'm Lorna Israel from Miriam College. I'm looking forward to meeting new friends, of course, eating new food, and how, as an educator, I can contribute to preserving our cultural heritage in whatever forms they come.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Okay, so anyone else? So one of it is sharing, kasi what Sir Manolo said a while ago, it's one of the output is education, sharing what you know from the cultural mapping. Anyone else who would like to share? How about, sir, I believe you were from the North Papo. Maybe you could share what are you looking forward to this year and who you are. Thank you so much for the effort.
Magandang hapon po. Ako po si Ruel Rombawa. Kasama ko po ang aking anak, si Red River, o Pulang Ilog ang tawag namin sa kanya. Ako po ay pinanganak sa bayan ng Kamiling Tarlac, ang hometown ni Leonor Rivera, Jose Rizal Maria Clara. I'm looking forward to assistance from GKI. We are losing a lot in terms of heritage in Kamiling. Of course, heritage houses being sold. The Maria Clara Museum already in Manila. I'm on a personal advocacy and mission. I'm on my half life, and I would like to bring back the beauty and cultural pride in Kamiling Tarlac. So, sana po matulungan ako ng GKI. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you also for bringing it to the attention of the GKI. You know that it's really happening now in certain area. And yun din yung winawarn sa atin, Sir Manolo, that we are slowly forgetting some of our culture and in line for the development. Anyone else would like to share, especially people online? Okay. Okay, please let us know. Maybe you can share people online who you are and what are you looking forward to this year. Okay. Okay, so without further ado, I would like to call on Sir Lito to discuss the exciting things that we look forward to this year. Okay, the activities.
Thank you, Christine. 2023-2024 calendar of activities. For April, of course, Architect Manolo mentioned already Torrijos Cultural Mapping Project. It's ongoing to be conducted on site with online option. We'll need two volunteers to go to Torrijos to help facilitate the community validation activities. Next. May 2023, Pamana Talks. Pamana Talks, theme for Pamana Talks on May, National Heritage Month. It's still to be determined what topics, and we need one volunteer to co-host the Pamana Talks. Next. May 29 to 30 is the Culture-Based Governance Conference in Naga, Camarines Sur. We'll need two GKI volunteers who can go to Naga in Camarines Sur to help the NCCA project team to facilitate the two-day conference. Next. June 2023, Kapamana Tour in Rizal, hoping we will do that. Volunteer Engagement Committee, to which I'm one of them, to need a team of four volunteers to organize the tour in Morong, Baras, Tanay, and Pililia. Organizing team to coordinate with other committees, marketing and communication, accounting and finance. And July 2023, there's the Bayong session, which is like our brown bag sessions, wherein we call for one GKI member to conduct a one-hour session to share his knowledge about a specific topic subject in local heritage. The volunteer engagement committee needs a team of two volunteers to organize the online Bayong session or brown bag session. For August 2023, there's the Kapamana Tour, hopefully in Quezon. Volunteer Engagement Committee to need a team of four volunteers to organize the tour in Lukban, Tayabas, and Sariaya. Organizing team to coordinate with other committees with marketing and communication and accounting and finance. For September 2023, another Bayong session. Calling for one GKI member again to conduct a one-hour session to share his knowledge about specific topics on heritage. Volunteer Engagement Committee again to need a team of two volunteers. Next. July to November 2023 is the GKI Cultural Mapping Training Program for Batch 13 with Asian Institute of Management. Training and Development Committee to lead this activity. We'll need six volunteers to form this committee. Planning activities to start as early as July. Marketing and promotions to start by late August. Registration will start by September. Course proper to start October to November. January 2024, GKI's 8th anniversary. So Volunteer Engagement Committee again to need a team of four volunteers to organize the anniversary event. And then organizing team to coordinate with other committees, the marketing and communication and accounting and finance. By March 2024, which is like a year from now, the annual general membership again and meeting and election of trustees. Volunteer Engagement Committee is the one in charge to need a team of four volunteers to organize that event. And then organizing team to coordinate with other committees also.
the ad hoc election committee must be formed not later than January 15, 2024. So that's basically it for our calendar of activities for the following year. We hope you can all join us.
Thank you so much, Sir Lito. So we have a lot of things or exciting things in store for you this year. Okay, a lot of things to look forward to. But to start now, let's start now. This new or this things to look forward to can happen now as we are blessed to have such a distinguishable guest in the field of culture and art. Okay, so we have a distinguishable guest to be part of our keynote speaker. I will give the honor to give the introduction of our keynote speaker to Architect Manolo Noches. Sir Manolo?
Okay, thank you very much. The keynote speaker that we have invited is a very renowned person in the fields of heritage, culture, and the arts, and we are very fortunate for her to have accepted our invitation for this particular event. The name Armita Bantug Rufino is synonymous with the arts. From music, dance, theater, literary, visual arts, fashion, film, and other art forms, she is very much an authority. Mrs. Rufino was once the president of the Cultural Center of the Philippines from 1998. To date, she is the president of the Filipino Festival Heritage Festival Inc., or FHFI, a private nonprofit organization that believes in the preservation and promotion of cultural treasures on the country, of the country, both its tangible and intangible. Every May, FHFI does a series of a month-long series of programs and events, from exhibits to cultural presentations around the country, promoting Philippine heritage, culture, and the arts. As we are about to be just two more months for this particular momentous event, of course, this is very much anticipated by the arts community in the Philippines, the heritage and arts community in the Philippines. It is with her drive and ambition, together with the National Commission for Culture and the Arts, the Presidential Proclamation number 439 to celebrate the National Heritage Month was promulgated in May 2003 under then President GMA? Yes, under Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. She is currently the District 17 Foundation Endowment Ambassador of Zonta International, covering the countries of Hong Kong, Thailand, Singapore, Malaysia, and of course, the Philippines. A grand lady, always on the go, adventurous, and results-oriented. For Mita, for her friends, the mission to keep arts and culture alive is a never-ending passion, commitment, and dedication. May I call and may I introduce to you Armita Bantug Rufino. Yes.
Okay. Chairman Lito Ligon, President Manolo Noche, who have been working for some time, and members of the Grupo Kalinangan. Good afternoon to everyone. I accepted this invitation to speak about the Renaissance in heritage. But I'm not an expert in this, but I have spent 18 years of planning and implementing programs for the Heritage Month. It was in 2003 when FHFI, or Filipino Heritage Festival Inc., together with the National Commission of Culture and the Arts, that President Presidential Proclamation 439 was signed by President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, declaring, of course, the Heritage Month of May as the Heritage Month. The first event that we had in 2003 was in September at the Presidential, at the Philippine Plaza Hotel, which is now a Sofitel. We were able to have, to invite two vintas, which were brought in by the Philippine Coast Guard, because at that time I was an honorary member, commander of the Philippine Coast Guard. And they were able to bring two vintas to Manila. And this was, they were floating, they were there around the Sofitel, around the Philippine Plaza Hotel at that time. And we also had a collaboration with UNESCO. We had a competition on making of the, the kites. We were able to have a collaboration with UNESCO. I have this feeling every time when I go to Japan, Thailand, Korea, and other neighboring countries, that the moment you land, you already know that you have arrived to such a country. There is that atmosphere of discipline and instructors that you can see the identity of the place, which shows their sense of pride of who they are. Filipinos in general are known to be very hospitable people, and this is what everybody is saying, that they love the Philippines because Philippines is a very hospitable country. But there seemed to be that lack of knowledge of being our very own. We have the tendency to be Westerners. For the last 19 years, I have been having heritage activities. Though we see some progress, yet there is still much to be done. During election times, we continue to have heritage events just to make the public aware of our own very heritage. And even during the lockdown, we had on the social media, and thank God that people or Filipinos were interested in virtual communication. Our country is an archipelago composed of more than 7,100 islands. Philippines is so diverse when we think of heritage. We have gone through many influences from Spain, Mexico, and other neighboring countries such as China, Japan, Korea. It was Spain that ruled for more than 300 years, the longest. It is said that even prior to the arrival of the different foreign countries, especially Spain, in our land, we already had our existing form of government and with governing laws. Like, for example, the King of Sulu, Padoka Pahala, during the 1400s, was invited by the Emperor of China. He accepted the invitation and went to China, and he was hosted and entertained by the Emperor. When he came back to the Philippines, he died in Shandong. And as of now, you can still see the tomb of the King of Sulu as one of their heritage place in Shandong, if you happen to go to Shandong. And with, in relation to this, we were able to have a collaboration with China. the making, filming of the King and the Emperor. I don't know if you have seen this film, which was done by the Cultural Center of the Philippines. We had to go to China to be able to discuss with them if they would agree for us to have that King and the Emperor film. And this was directed by then Eddie Romero. And if I remember right, the actor was Vic Vargas, maybe not yet during their time. That's why here. I don't know about you, Manolo, if you know about Vic Vargas. Our geography of the composition of the country, composed of three major islands, Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. Each one has its own unique culture, traditions, characters, moral, social values, traits, heritage. And yet, it is interesting to note that our country, even with its internal conflicts, is distinctly united as one. If we look back, our Renaissance, rebirth or rediscovery may have been during the Spanish rule and the early foreign settlers when the Philippines had started the activities of the various fields, in the various fields, when foreign culture had come to our land, business and trade prospered, and ongoing with Asian neighboring countries and cultures and national identity prevailed. Life was then quite simple. People lived with content and national identity. However, when the coming of other foreign visitors influences about transformations and major makeover of what is truly Filipino and its identity, our country has been a fusion of East and West. And I was just discussing earlier with Manolo, and when you ask Filipinos, what do you want to eat? McDonald's. Why McDonald's? I mean, is that a Philippine food, a Filipino food? So really, we have to be able to know who we are and what we have, what is local and what is imported. Heritage is inherent to us Filipinos. We get so attached to the possessions. But articles, especially if it has been given to us as a gift of value. Heritage is an inheritance, a legacy, a tradition, a custom, culture, or birthright. Heritage, as we know in Tagalog, is pamana. It's our link to the past that leads us to the future. As Rizal once said, ang hindi marunong tumingin sa kanyang pinanggalingan, hindi makakarating sa kanyang patutunguhan. But most important, it is the present that brings both the past and the future. Heritage get to have an impact and value on the present. Further, both the past and present bring about and look into the bright future of another set of generation. One cannot have sense of pride and belonging without living in the present. Our self-identity leads us to unity, to know oneself and recognize who we truly are. From our history, culture, geography, indigenous peoples, architecture, legends, mythology, festivals, folklore, and more, much, much more, brought about by the lifestyle in transformation, have become a major part in the discovery and rebirth in our land, in our heritage. Because I believe in the importance and significance of the heritage, in 2003, we felt the need to create the Filipino Heritage Festival, Inc., a private and non-profit organization, was duly registered in 2004 with the SEC. I would like to share also maybe something that I even fought with my friend's husband. He was saying that, oh, you Filipinos are second-class citizen in the United States. Thank you. That is better. You're second-class citizens. And I said, what? And you British. He was a British. The husband was a British. And he was trying to apply to immigrate in the United States. I said, look at you. You're a British. And you are going to immigrate to America? Do you love your country? Is that how much you love your country? Look at us. We studied in America, but we came home because we wanted to do something for our country. So after that, when they went home, my friend and him really fought because our friend said, you have no right to say like that. So it really depends on how much you feel about your country. FHFI, and because I believe in that importance and significance, so that's why we created the FHFI. FHFI initiated and lobbied for the presidential proclamation of the Heritage Month. NCCA was tasked to be the lead agency. The important factor then was the partnership between government and private sector. Why in May? May apparently has the most festivities in all the months of in our country. And it's really appropriate to have it in May. You know, there are more than hundreds of festivals, of festivities in the Philippines during the month of May. We have the known ones, which is the Santa Cruz de Mayo, the Flores de Mayo, the Pahiyas, and they have the Balanghay. And so these are only a few of what is really happening during the month of May. FHFI, barely on its 20th year, has taken the challenge, commitment, dedication, and passion to promote heritage with the objective of preserving and conserving the national and natural resources, both tangible and intangible. What is heritage and its importance? Heritage is what we have inherited from the past, which we give value to and in the present appreciate and enjoy. We have to enjoy also our heritage. We cannot just put it aside and say, oh, that's only our heritage. No, we have also to enjoy it. But as time goes by, the value is preserved and passed on to the future generation, with a vision to continue, evolve, and pursue. The Proclamation 439 was signed in August 12, 2023. That's why we were able to have that event at the Philippine Plaza during the month of September. That was the only time that we had it in a different month. There's a need to create among the people of consciousness. respect and pride for the legacies of Filipino cultural history and love of country. The whole country is given a chance to highlight and appreciate its cultural treasures. It is also an occasion to raise awareness on their significance. Considering the significance of this annual celebration in May, to honor our traditions and customs, our government encourages the involvement of the private sector so that the propagation of our country's unique heritage will be able to reach more Filipinos who need to be made aware. Be appreciative and the need to preserve these traditions and landmarks that are pressured by the onslaught of development and globalization. Because of that, a lot of people, a lot of Filipinos have really forgotten our very own. They become so westernized, and they always say, like I would, you know, sometimes when you go abroad, you would ask, are you, because it, to show you we are quite islanders, are you a Filipino? No, I am an Ilocano. Well, isn't an Ilocano a Filipino? So sometimes because we have so many islands, we think that maybe we're not Filipinos, we are Cebuano, or we are Negros, or, you know. So that's why it's very important for us, for your group, to be able to make this public really aware that as one, we are all Filipinos. May I add that it's during this time that there had been so many changes, fluctuations, deviation, medications, and the worldwide pandemic. We all have witnessed, however, while the time changes, you must have to move on and evolve with the times. We cannot just stay put. We cannot just remain as it is. As Architect Noche said, that we have to move on. This had effects on the preservation and conservation, yet improvements we must to improve and develop with the importance of our preserving our heritage. I will give you now the concept of the FHFI, a month-long celebration of tangible and intangible Filipino heritage presented through cultural events, deliberately utilizing heritage sites and malls. You know why malls? We used to have it only on heritage homes, on museums, but we didn't get as many attendees. But when we started bringing it to the malls, there were much more attendees, because you know malls have different levels, so they are watching what is happening there. So that's the reason why we use the malls. It is a point project of the National Commission for Culture and the Arts and the private sector, represented by the FHFI. What are the objectives? To raise the consciousness of the average Filipino of the existence of these marvelous man-made as well as natural landmarks, the needs to cherish and preserve them. Second, to institutionalize and foster the month of May as the National Heritage Month. Third, to animate and focus attention on Filipino cultural heritage through various cultural events that will encompass, address, and include the different tiers of society. So it should not be only on the A, B, it should really from A, B, C, D, E, F, G, whatever it is. So it should really for everyone. You know, I could also say that there are a lot of people up there who don't know anything about heritage. Sorry to say about that. I have friends that would rather buy imported products. Like, for example, we're going to have our, I'm talking of Sonta, we're going to have our regional conference in Taiwan. And they were in Korea. They were all buying their Korean products because we usually give away to our friends or to, you know, those who are attending the conference. And they told me, why aren't you buying? Why will I buy here? I'd like to buy something that's made in the Philippines. Why will I buy something from Korea when I want to give that to the Taiwanese? I want the ones that, from the Philippines, that when I go to Taiwan, I can say it's made in the Philippines. So that's really something that, you know, to think about. To animate and focus attention on Filipino cultural heritage through various cultural events that will encompass, address, and include the different tiers of society. Number four, to act as unifying force in the society through the use of heritage. With the efforts of FHFI, allow me to share with everyone here a number of highlights we have accomplished. From exhibitions, to performing arts, music, dance, literary, heritage tours, and many more various projects, programs, activities, which we do it only really during the Heritage Month. We have been a staunch provider of the importance and the need to promote and encourage, foster the Filipino. Here are some highlights of the various activities and projects. One, the national artist, architect Leandro Loxin, and architect Ildefonso Santos, we had an exhibit of their works at the Metropolitan Museum. Second, a series of exhibits of your very own president, Manolo Noche. I think you can show them there, the works of Manolo. And the visual arts done by Larry Alcala, which we are bringing down the Negros area. But it's going to be also shown at the Makati City Museum during May, during the month of May. In dance, we have the enchanted journeys of the Hudhud on an original indigenous peoples from the highlands of the Cordilleras, which was shown at the Cultural Center of the Philippines. We were able to bring them. At first, we were not allowed, but later on, they allowed us to bring down these people from the Cordilleras, so they were able to sing and chant during the show. And also, we have the Darangini Bantugan, which was also shown at the CCP, and this is naman from Mindanao area. We had an exhibit of the flora and fauna of the country in partnership with IRI. And then we have the famous mountains in the Philippines, rivers, and lakes. And music, Himing ng Bayan, a tribute of national artists for music. And one of them was Ramon Santos. And he was invited to go to Japan by the Philippine Embassy to give a lecture on music and the instrument, Filipino instruments, because he has a big collection of the Philippine instruments. If there is one country that has festivals throughout the year, 365 days, and that's the Philippines. This May, we celebrate the Heritage Month with the theme, Change and Continuity. There can be a little change, but I think we should continue our heritage, maybe with a slight change or what, but you know, the basic should not be lost. I believe it as an appropriate theme as we go through transformation, and we are all witnesses to the change, and we should all be part of the continuity to the preservation and improvement of our heritage in this fast-paced moving times. And one last thing, to inculcate in the minds of the young, I really believe and wish that educating them at an early age is necessary, very necessary. You go to Japan, you see these kids going to the museum, going to their heritage places, going to look at all those statues of their ancestors, of their heroes. And that should be done by our young, starting maybe at kindergarten if possible, so that they will know their identity at an early age and love of country. I really find it important for the Department of Education to include in the curriculum of the young the importance of the country's heritage. As we say in FHFI, unity through heritage. Thank you.
Once again, thank you so much, Ma'am Rufino, for that inspiring talk. I think the thing that resonates to us more is, for me rather, is that to know ourselves, we must know our beliefs, our stories, or our heritage. So for us to get to know each other, we need to get into or delve into each and everyone's stories, diba? Okay, now, for the last agenda of the meeting, before we get to socialize, so yun na yung part na isa sa mga fun activity na naka-reserve for today. Let's have first the introductions of different committees. I would like to call Sir Lito once again to give us the different introductions for the committee. Sir Lito?
Okay, now comes the meaty part. I'm going to tell you now the different committees involved in under the GKI. The first one is the Cultural Mapping Partnership Committee. This is the critical one. This is what the forte of GKI is cultural mapping. Helps facilitate the implementation of cultural mapping projects with client LGUs, meaning the local government units. And then there's the facilitating leads generations, meetings with LGU clients, and proposal creation and negotiation. Engaging with civic organizations also, aside from the LGUs, during cultural mapping activities. Next, that's one committee. There's also the Training and Development Committee. They lead in planning, implementation, and evaluation of the annual cultural mapping training program. They develop the training program and the content of it all. They communicate with the resource persons and the partners, invite them, and then they promote also the training program for prospective participants, coordinate the logistical needs for the conduct of training. Next. Volunteer Management and Community Engagement Committee. Well, basically that's what my committee, and responsible for attracting, retaining, and recognizing GKI volunteers. And then it also creates a system and structures to ensure that the volunteers are effectively involved. In other words, not just with cultural mapping, there's also the brown bag or Bayong sessions and other talks that they consistently join our activities, managed and supported. Then there's responsible also for developing volunteer engagement strategy for retention, creating and updating volunteer policies and processes. There's the campaigning GKS goals and missions to the volunteers. There's also responsible for engaging and expanding the organization's network with outside the within outside the cultural heritage community by creating different events and activities. So that's when we need ideas also in the area of history, heritage, culture, and the arts. Then aims to forge partnership with local organizations to help them expand their audience. The next. Fundraising, of course, organizations need that also. Fundraising and Donor Management Committee, they assume the responsibility of raising funds from grants and other sources to support the organization's mission. Then they also seek fundraising opportunities, creates plans, and analyzes relationships with current and prospective major donors and funders, and develop individualized strategies to cultivate or strengthen these relationships. And there's the Accounting, Finance, and Administration Committee. They have the fiduciary responsibility of ensuring that the financial matters of the organizations are regulatory body compliant while aligned with GKI's mission. They also prepare accurate and timely financial reports to the board. So those who like the numbers, who are always number crunching, can also volunteer for this. They maintain complete and accurate financial records, and then they lead the annual budget planning. Then there's the Programming, Monitoring, and Evaluations Committee. They help with annual programming and calendaring of GKI's programs, projects, and activities, and they gather and analyze outputs on outcomes of programs and projects of the organization. They provide recommendations also based on the outcomes of the project programs and reports them to the Board of Trustees. Next, Marketing and Communications Committee, the one usually being talked about earlier when I told you of the calendar of activities. They develop and implement GKI's strategic and marketing plan and promote its mission and vision to the core values and strategies of and services and activities. The activities involve creation of relevant content, the data gathering and analysis, and the development and updating of the communications and marketing plan for the GKI. That's basically it. And then if you want to join, you can press on the QR code. Ano naman, uso na ngayon ang QR code, everything's QR code. You press that so that you can join whatever committee you are in charge. Or there's also the link that goes to the GKI committee's sign up. You can sign up for that. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Sir Lito. So I hope you were able to get the picture and maybe think of what committee you are interested in, to take part in, to contribute your effort. And if not, I believe our email, you will receive emails and different materials from today so that you can register. Okay, so while you're contemplating what committee you want to be in, I'm sure everyone is hungry, no? So siguro lahat ay gusto nang magmerienda. And can't wait to eat sumptuous Filipino food there. So we have the buffet over here. So let's have our merienda now. You may go to the cocktail lounge at the back. So if you would see, there's tables at the back of our auditorium, and start socializing with your fellow members. So everyone, kain na! Enjoy your merienda! Huwag pong mahihiya. Marami po tayong Filipino food sa likod. Go ahead, everyone. For those who are online, no, it's time for you to eat your merienda din from your refrigerator.
Shall we start? So, let's start the game. G. Yes, the heritage. Pero so far, sino yung mga taga-onsite na nakasago? Oo, oh, may mga game surprises. Okay, ito. Share song per hit pa din. Ayan. Saan yan? Naku, patitensyon ninyo. Oh, is it Santa Cruz, Santa Ynez, Santa Fe, or Santa Ana? What's your game?
Bagak, sabi ni chairman of the board. Okay. So what's the right answer, Sir Lito? Oh, there. So, okay, sige, next. Sino kaya yung mga leading natin sa ating board over there? Sige, next lang. Para yung next lang. Okay, may nananalo si Engelbert Tali. Is this online or on-site? I guess online. Okay, sige, next. Let's go to the next. So, tuloy-tuloy lang siya. We have 15 questions, by the way. A Revolutionary Congress was inaugurated here on 1898. So, is it Bagak Church? Laging favorite ng ating mga trustees ang Bagak Church. Okay. What's your guess, Sir Lito?
Balinsayaw.
Balinsasayaw daw. Tama kaya yun? Okay. Time is up. Sige. Let's click next. And then, sino nangunguna? Aba, oy, may mga tumatas. Baka naman, ayan si Joyce. Ay, medyo lumalapit na kay Engelbert. Okay, next. Maybe Sir Lito can read this.
This is an example of translocated heritage structure. Where is it? So, what heritage structure is it?
Okay, is it Miranila House, Acuzar House, Quezon House, or Romualdez House? Okay, the right answer is?
Quezon House.
All right, Quezon House. Sige, next. Sige, anong masasabi ng ating mga ano? O ba, uy! Aba, si Jason na. Who's Jason? Is he here? Okay, online din. Alright, type. Okay, click next. Next. Question number 3. This heritage school bill is found in which city in the Visayas? Oh, familiar kayo dyan? Show of hands on the on-site. Sino yung nakapunta na dyan? Yung may nakapunta na dyan. Saan pa yan? Bagak pa rin, guys. Hello. Is it Cebu, Tacloban, Iloilo, or Dumaguete? What's your guess, Sir Lito?
Na, sinabi na. Dumaguete.
Very good. Okay, click next. Sino na yung ating nangunguna? Oh, si Jason pa rin ba? Aba, si Jason pa rin. By the way, may first, second, third, and fourth prize for this. Lahat pa sa lubong ni Sir Roe. Okay, next. Let's go. So we'll make it quick lang, parang next lang tayo. So parang, it's one of the largest church structures in the Philippines, found in which town? Bagak pa rin? Okay, ito medyo tricky. Ginawa ko siyang tricky para magkakalapit lang yung mga places. Is it Kaisasay? Is it Lemery? Is it Taal? Is it Apacible? So what's your answer?
Cuenca.
Cuenca? None of the above. Okay. Sige, next. The answer is Taal. Who's been to Taal, guys? So far. Wow, ang dami na napupunta sa mga heritage places. Good. Next. Sige, click next. Si Jason pa rin ba? Uy, si Maria Abigail. By the way, naka naman. Okay, next. Okay, a traditional attire from Mindanao, particularly from which cultural community? Ito yung picture. Oh, is it what? You can read the choices, Sir Lito.
Tibuli, Maranao, Blan, or Tausug? Which is your answer?
Okay, the correct answer is Baan, and then sino na nangunguna? Next. Oy, si Marie Abigail pa rin. Ako naman. Sige, sige, next. This old convent is found in which town in Visayas? Argao, Cebu? San Joaquin, Iloilo? Silay Negros? Or Lazi Sikihor? Sikijor? Sabi daw nila. O, naka-answer na ba lahat? I think everybody's done. Oh, there you go. Everybody's done. So, what's the right answer? Lazi Sikihor. Who's been to Lazi Sikihor? Well, medyo paunti ng paunti yata. Ata, kasi parang mas ano yun, no? Secluded na part yata. Although, yeah, that's Sikihor for you. Next. Let's click next. Yeah, nanguna pa rin ba si Maria Abigail? Oh, okay. Ito si Maria Abigail, Jason Engelbert. Nako, top three. Next. Yeah, let's click next. Question number 8. It is said to be the only all-steel church in the Philippines. What are the choices?
San Joaquin, San Sebastian, San Roque, San Andres. Controversial yun ngayon.
Okay. Sige. Okay, the right answer is San Sebastian Church, which is in which part of Manila? Quiapo. Good. Next. Click next. Okay, nanguna pa rin ba si... Ayun. O parang talaga naglalaban na lang yung top 3, yung 4th and 5th na lang yung umiikot, no? Okay, next. Let's click next. Question number 9. An interesting heritage structure in QC inspired by a medieval castle. Can you read the choices, Sir Lito?
Quezon Institute, Asian Technology Theological Seminary, Christ the King Seminary, or SVD, Mission House.
Oh, sige. Sama ka, assistant game master, come on. Richard. Joke lang. Okay. The answer is Christ the King Seminary. So next, sino na yung nangunguna? Sila pa rin ba? Uy! Ah, okay, merong aba, si Renz is making a comeback with 3 in a row. Okay, next. Question number 10. Historic structure in the center of Intramuros. Ano yan? By the way, mga photos na to, courtesy of our chairman. Mga photos niya to, by the way. So siya yung katulong ko talaga sa pag-planning ng game na to. So is it Palacio del Gobernador, Aduana, Real Audiencia, or may last pa to answer? Ayan, ayun, the right answer is Ayuntamiento. Okay, so next. Click next. Tama pa rin ba? Uy! Aba, umaangat si Engelbert. Alright, next. 11th question out of 15. A type of Filipino folk dance. Siyempre, para hindi naman laging buildings, let's go on something intangible. Alright. Ito, tricky to. Minake sure ka talaga medyo tricky to. Pag hindi kayo masyadong familiar sa Filipino folk dance, baka... By the way, ito yung Filipino folk dance ko nung PE ko sa college. So, hip-hop? Okay, naka-answer na ba lahat? Okay, the answer is... Baka yung iba nag-answer ng pandango sa ilaw. Okay, sige, next. Tingnan natin kung tama sila or nagkamali. Uy, si Fred! Aba, nag-number one si Fred, guys. Okay, medyo nagbabago na ang ating kapalaran. Okay, sige, let's click next. Another type of Filipino folk dance. So what are these? Taken by habang kumakain si Sir Lito doon sa Barbaras. Ayun na picture. Ganun ba 'yun? Okay. Is it itik-itik, maglalatik, tinikling, or cariñosa? Okay, last one to answer. May inihintay na lang isa. So the answer is maglalatik. Sino marunong? Meron bang marunong? Wala. Okay. Ayaw lang umamin. Yun yun eh. Joke lang. Okay, next. Okay. Ayan, tinubo na bago yung kapalaran, guys. So talaga meron pang chance yung mga nandun sa mga top 6 to 10. Okay, so click next. Okay, next. Somewhere in Bulacan. O sige, Sir Lito, read the choices.
May Kawayan, Malolos, Marilao, or Baliwag, San Miguel.
San Miguel. Ang gulo. San Miguel, Baraswaid. Ganun. Bustos. SJDM. Okay. So the answer is Malolos. That's the Malolos Cathedral. Who's been to Malolos? At na-try na ang ano yung empanada? Kaliskis. Meron bang nakatry na nun? Ayun. Next. So sino na? Nabago ba ang kapalaran? Uy, si Fred pa rin. And si Engelbert na doon sa pang fifth spot. Okay, kaya pa yan. We still have two more questions. Okay, go. Sunburn Bisaya, sige. Sir Lito.
Darwin Negros Oriental, Lassie Siquijor, Dalaguete Cebu, or Jordan Guimaras? Ang sagot, Bacolod.
Ang sagot, Bacolod. Okay. Yan. So, alam niyo ba yung answers of the ones on site here? Sino na nakapunta dito? Para mas konti yung nakapunta na dito. Bakit? Lazy ba yun? Okay, so it's a steal. Joke na. Tama ba? So, yun, ako yung mali. Okay, sorry po. Lazy ba yun? It's lazy. Okay, sige. Sige, click next. Bonus na lang. Okay. Uy. Oh, there. Okay, sige. May last na lang. Sige. Last. Dito na talagang malalaman ko sino ang magwawagi dun sa ating mga pasalubong from Sir Rove. Okay, saan nito? Actually, magkakamukha sila, kaya pinili kong ganyan. Kasi mga civic buildings natin during the American period, mas ganyan yung mga style. So, what are the choices?
Marinduque, Leyte, Pangasinan, or Negros Occidental?
No, Manila City Hall. Okay, the answer is Negros Occidental. Sino na nakapunta ng Bacolod here? Wow, nice. Okay, eto na. Sino nang ready malaman ang totoong kapalaran ng bawat isa? Last. Eto na yung leaderboard natin. Tadan! Okay, number 3, Mark Anthony. Number 2, Abigail T. Number 1. Tadadadan! Para may background music, insert background music na lang. Okay. Yehey! Okay, paki-screenshot po para may ebidensya na sila po yung nanalo. Okay. Ito yung mga prizes. Sige, magtulungan tayo, Sir Lito, kung ano yung mga prizes na yan. Sige, open natin. Sige, ito, sa loot bag ni Sir Rome. Ano yan? Oh, it's a kape from Pikit, North Cotabato. From Cotabato. Ah, there. Oh, next. What's in the loot bag? From? Okay. Meron bang taga-onsite na nanalo? Wow! You're Fred or Mark Anthony? Mark Anthony, congratulations. So you get the kape. Gusto mo kape or pili? Kasi baka hindi nagkakape, kaya ako naman tinatanong. Hindi naman namimili lang. Kape, you like kape? Ah, there. Okay. And then the rest would win, si Maria Abigail for the second prize would win the pili nut brittle. Tada, from Camarines Sur. Tama? Tama ba? O tama. And then the last one, the winner, si Fred, would get Pili Nut and one coffee from Cotabato and the Pili Nut from Naga, right? Yes, congratulations! Okay, we have second games. Itong second game, it only goes for the... Ito masaya yung prize, guys. Kailangan kayo mag-participate. Perhaps... Christine, can you also help? Okay lang ba? Ayun. To distribute ang tinatawag nating game na kung tawagin, Bingo, Human Bingo. Sinong familiar, Human Bingo? We can finally do this on-site na. Kasi dati for the longest time, we were not able to do this. So, ang mechanics dito, top 3. Okay, ito si Sir Manolo.
Ang sasali dito sa grand prize natin will win books. The third prize book is top 3. It's this one, Hobby. So it's a book about textiles. Number two is Kain Na, an illustrated guide to Philippine food. And our grand prize is, I'm sure you all want to have this, the Boxer Codex. Okay, so please join because the prizes we're giving is very much rare and in demand.
Okay, sige. So ang game natin is Human Bingo. So I hope meron kayong mga yun lang yung concern ah. Basta mechanics, meron kayong ballpen, and then you have to go around and look for that guy na magko-correspond doon sa nakasulat sa ating human bingo. Pero somehow in order to enrich naman yung ating activity, tanungin niyo kung ano yung thing na yun na nagko-correspond. For example, ang naka-mention yata diyan, I've been to this certain place. I know how to do this. Itong particular tradition na ito. Tanungin nyo kung ano yung tradition na yun. Hindi lang yung parang sinulat yun yung name pass para manalo kayo ng boxer codex. Wag ganun. Let's enrich naman. Let's make it engaging as well because ang aim natin talaga dito for this activity, it's mas makilala natin ang bawat isa. So clear ba so far? Nakakuha na ba lahat? Show of hands, sino nang meron at sasali para manalo ng boxer codex book? Okay. Ha? Para mananalo, yung top 3 na unang lalapit dito, ang siyang mananalo. Okay? Meron pang iba. Okay, sige. Alright, so again, this goes to the on-site participants. So are guys ready? Sino nang ready? Say G if you're ready. Ayan, parang hina guys. Ayaw nyo manalo ng boxer codex. G ba or not G? Okay, on that note, in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Game. Sige, ikot kayo. At syempre, look around at baka nakikita nyo na ang inyong mga kamatching for that human bingo. For those on virtual, babasahin ko na lang sa inyo and maybe my fellow assistant game master would help me read some of the things here. So, yeah, according to the bingo, ito yung mga dapat na mahanap ng mga participants on-site. Sige, can you name at least 3 of them? Just read through.
I know how to cook. I know how to cook a unique Filipino cuisine. I have varied I've visited both Batanes and Tawi-Tawi, and I have been to all 3 National Museum buildings in Manila.
Okay, so yung mga na-mention ni Sir Lito, yun yung hahanapin nyo around. Kung lahat ba ay nagko-correspond dito. So for example, again, for the online participants, one example is, I know how to cook a unique Filipino cuisine. So mag-aanap sila kung sino yung marunong talaga ng isang unique Filipino cuisine. Pag sinabi namang unique, it could be something subjective naman. Like, perhaps sa inyo, yung unique Filipino cuisine is adobo. O sige, tatanggapin na namin kasi para sa inyo talaga, unique talaga yung adobo nyo. Okay lang din naman yun, di ba? Di ba? Kung para sa inyo ay unique na yung adobo nyo. Or perhaps something else na very interesting. Oh, were you able to finish na? Wow. Autograph. So, what's your name?
Jason.
Jason in the house. And then the second one. Wow. Ito na, yung mga gustong manalo. Okay, what's your name?
Leo.
Okay, we got Jason and Leo. And who's the lucky top 3? Pero we need to confirm, ha? Sana naman naalala nyo kung sino yung mga person na yun na sinama nyo. Okay, basahin ko lang ulit for the online participants. Yung mga choices dito, I know how to cook a unique Filipino cuisine. Perhaps you can type down in the chat ano yun, di ba? Kung meron din kayong alam. Tapos another one, I have visited both Batanes and Tawi-Tawi, both tail ends of the country. And then the other one, I have been to all 3 National Museum buildings in Manila. Ayan. And then the last 3, I have visited a UNESCO World Heritage Site in the Philippines. Then, the second to the last, I can perform a traditional Filipino musical piece. And then, the last one, ito yung siguro masaya, I have visited Fort Santiago more than 5 times in my lifetime. Oh, baka meron dyan nagko-correspond sa inyo sa on-site, sa online. Okay, sino ba una talagang nalapit dito? Okay. Okay, mas nauna siya. Okay, pero perhaps kung hindi man mag-a-apply, then you can keep it with you, hold it with you. Okay, so yung top 1, top 2, top 3, perhaps may magsisteal, it could be, ayan, stay put lang. Okay, sige, so we got Sir Jason, okay, ano yung mga, sino yung mga nakilala mo?
So we have Luis, yung nagluto ng Filipino cuisine.
So anong Filipino cuisine?
Ay,
naku! Ito kaya yung isang mechanics na hindi siya papasa? De, sige, saan si Luis?
Saan si Luis? Ayan.
Like, ano yung niluluto mo? Pancit Malabon daw. Sabi ni Richard, hindi naman unique yun. This is joke lang kasi taga Malabon siya. Okay, what else?
Sir Brian sa nakapag-visit na ng Batanes and Tawi-Tawi.
Wow, sana all. Batanes, Tawi-Tawi.
And Miss Noche. Ay, sir. Sir Noche has been to all the three buildings. National Museum.
Okay, who yung sige, you can name the rest of the three.
Mark, Rem, and Joel.
Okay, so pasado ba ako President Manolo, would you accept? Biglang may ganun pala. Okay, si Jason ang top 1, top 2. Okay.
Yes sir. I know how to cook a unique Filipino cuisine. Laing po yung nasulat ko kasi laing yung nasabi. It's Ma'am Lorna po pala. I have visited both Batanes and Tawi-Tawi, si Sir Noche po. Yes, I have been to all three National Museum buildings in Manila, si Ma'am Irish po. And then UNESCO site po, si Sir Christian, si Sir Ben po, I can perform traditional Filipino musical piece. And yung ating pong MC kanina, I have visited Port Santiago more than 5 times in my lifetime, sir.
More than 5 times, make it 6. And then, top 3. Okay, what's your name?
Hello, ako po si Red River. So, yung sa I know how to cook unique Filipino cuisine, Sir Joel nasa. Tapos I have visited both Batanes and Tawi-Tawi, si Sir Brian. I have been to all three National Museum buildings in Manila, Sir Joel din po ulit. And then for both, sir, I have visited the UNESCO World Heritage Site in PH sa Buhulto, in church, and then can perform a traditional Filipino musical piece yung sa father ko, si Sir Rowe.
Can I ask, what kind of musical piece? Kubing. Wow. Parang siyempre, gusto ko sana yung sample. Wala eh. Anyway.
And then lastly, I have visited Fort Santiago in more than 5 times in my lifetime, si Ma'am Risty.
Ay, talagang ito. Okay, on that note, magkakaroon tayong award-giving ceremony, courtesy of President Manolo Noche. Okay, background music na gusto niyo yung pang-graduation ceremony. Okay. Okay, for the hobby book, we got, yeah, Sir Red River. Ay, may picture ba? Oh. Diba? Cum laude. For magna cum laude, we got... The book entitled Kain Na, an illustrated guide to Philippine food by Felice Prudente Santa Maria. Uy, wala pa ako lahat ng mga books na yun, by the way. Okay. And then, the Summa Cum Laude with Boxer Codex, Sir Jason. Okay, on that note, maraming salamat for joining the activity. Sana may nakilala din naman kayong fellow GKI members, both online and on-site. And on that note, on behalf of my fellow assistant game master, it's been Stephen. So makita-kita po tayo sa mga susunod na GKI activities. Maraming salamat!
Hi, once again, thank you so much to our game master, Sir Stephen and Sir Lito. Okay, nag-enjoy naman po ang lahat. Ay, parang hindi, sir. Isa pa daw. Char. Just kidding. Because as much as we want to continue the game, the socialization, sadly, we have to conclude the event. Before we end, again, may we remind you that we will have our group photo session after the closing remark. The first here at the stage. The second one is in the second floor spolarium of the National Museum. After we take our first group photo here at the stage, we shall proceed together in the spolarium. With this, I would like to give the stage to Mr. Joel Ador, the trustee and founder of Grupong Kalinangan for the closing remark. Sir Joel?
Hello. Unong abala pa rin kahit na. ayun. I would like to thank everyone who made this general membership meeting very, very wonderful and fabulous. Maraming, maraming salamat. Give yourselves a warm round of applause. Ayan. Specifically, of course, I'd like to acknowledge the following. No, I have my notes just in case ano, baka may malimutan ako. So first and foremost, I'd like to thank our organizing committee. First, through the leadership, of course, ng ating butihing chairman, si Lito Ligon, palakpakan po natin si Chairman Lito. And to the members, si Kuya Ben, na nagbigay ng ating ano, team yung mga ating photo and video documentation team. To Ms. Leilani, to Alan, Marquise, to Anthony, sila yung nagmamando po ng ating registration booth. Halos din na nakasama sa mga ano, activities kanina. Of course, to Stephen, thank you very much for facilitating the games. And of course, to our Master of Ceremonies, si Ms. Christine, maraming salamat. Also, special thanks to our annual report team. Sila po yung nag-prepare over the last 2 months ng ating annual report for 2022. So, kasama po natin dito si Irish, ating corporate secretary, at mga kasama po namin si Julian Castro, si Joshua Castillo, also si ating bagong member na graphic designer, si Daniel Ardemer. Maraming salamat po. Would like to thank Libreria Filipiniana for sponsoring the prizes, yung mga libro po natin, and for being a partner of GKI in our fundraising activities. Maraming salamat. To the team of Kulay Productions, Brian Plaza and his team, thank you for providing us with this wonderful AV setup and yung live stream po natin para makasali po ang ating mga members who cannot come here physically. To Chef Nex and her team of waiters and cooks for the fabulous, wonderful Filipino merienda. Maraming salamat po. Also, to our very special guests who already left, si ating butihing keynote speaker, si Mrs. Armita Rufino of Filipino Heritage Festival, Inc. Maraming salamat po. Of course, this wouldn't be possible without the support of our friends from the National Museum of the Philippines through our friend, the Director General Jeremy Barnes and his team from the Museum Services for allowing us to hold this very special location here at the National Museum of Fine Arts Building Auditorium. Maraming salamat. And to the leadership of Grupo Kalinangan, namely to our president, Manolo. Kahit sabihin mo, accidental lang yung ano, pagka-presidente, maraming salamat sa leadership nyo. And also to our chairman, Lito Ligon, for giving life to our volunteer engagement. And to our fellow trustees, si Rome Candaza from Cultural Mapping Partnerships and Richard Bautista, our consultant for all consulting work. And of course, lahat po ng mga old and new members na nandito po ngayon sa auditorium at syempre po sa mga kasama po natin sa live stream. Maraming salamat po, Kapamana. Alam nyo, 7 taon na po kami dito sa Grupo Kalinangan at hindi po talaga biro-biro na gawain sa Pamana. Kami po sa Grupo Kalinangan, nakaranas na po kami ng mga pagsubok, nakaranas na rin kami ng mga kabiguan over the past 7 years. Pero nagkaroon din po kami ng maraming mga tagumpay at mga natupad na pangako at mga gawain. Siguro dahil rin sa pagpupursige namin at siyempre yung aming adhikain, yung talagang totoo yung adhikain namin. Kasama na rin yung pagtitiis dahil talagang susubukan ka talaga eh. Dito sa gawain na to, marami talagang pagtitiis kang gagawin. Pero alam namin na itong gawain na to talagang talagang pagdadaanan namin do eh. Kasi kung gusto natin na mayroong mangyari para sa ating pamana at lahat naman tayo gusto magkaroon ng pagbabago para sa ating pamana, lalo na maraming halos araw-araw na babalitaan natin ang mga demolitions, mga nasisira, mga heritage structures. And siguro minsan nagiging numb na tayo sa mga ganong news eh. Pero we always remind ourselves, bakit nga ba tayo sumasaya sa mga ganitong adikain? At bakit tayo nandito sa Grupo Kalinangan? No? Hindi ito libangan na isang bigayan lang. Ayan, ito na yung ating contribution, ito na yung ating ambag sa pamana. Ang gawain ay tuloy-tuloy, paulit-ulit, at matagalan. Ginagawa natin ito paulit-ulit, matagalan, hanggang sa makamtan ng minimithi. Dahil naniniwala kami na heritage and heritage conservation is a long game, no? Kaya po kayo na kasabi po namin ngayon dito sa Grupo Kalinangan, lalo na sa mga bagong kasama po namin, mga bagong members, sana po makita po namin kayo na mag-participate pa. Gaya nga po na sinabi ng ating butihing presidente, ang ating mantra ngayon ay involvement, active involvement. Sana po sa mga susunod na araw, buwan, taon, makasama po namin kayo sa mga gawain. At kami naman po, narito po kami para umalalay po sa inyo. At malalaman nyo kung paano talaga makipaglaban para sa minamahal nating kultura at pamana. At hanggat narito tayo mga nandito na miyembro, gumagawa pa rin ng totoong gawain para sa ating kultura at pamana, may pag-asa palagi para sa ating Kalinangan. So maraming salamat, mabuhay ang Kalinangan, mabuhay ang pamanang Pilipino.
Thank you so much, Sir Aldor. Once again, thank you everyone for attending both here on site and as well as online. Maraming salamat po sa pagdalo. We might be physically apart or we might physically part ways for now, but our collected actions and advocacy will felt true regardless where we are. Okay, salamat muli sa pagdalo. Mabuhay kayo, kapamana. Once again, congratulations everyone and thank you very much. Bago po tayo umalis, we would like to ask everyone to go in front for the photo op. We would like to ask the trustees, officers to please go up of the stage. Okay. Oh, hold on po muna. We'll ask po the people in the live stream to please turn on their camera, sir. Sa live stream daw po muna tayo. Okay, thank you po. Okay, people in the live stream, kindly turn on your cameras for a photo off. Yay! So thank you so much for attending. Ayan. We have a lot. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, smile. Isa pa. 1, 2, 3, smile. Salamat. Thank you po. Okay, so people here on site, kindly go in front for the photo op. So, siguro po yung mga trustees, yung mga board, they can go up in the stage as well as the girls, the ladies. Pwede pong sa stage po tayo and the gentlemen can be in the below the stage. Kayo na lang po bahalang mag-blocking. Yes po. Wag po kayong mahiya. Kindly go in front po for the photo off. Yes. If you're hindi naman sa pero kung short po kayo and the ladies po, I suggest that you take the stage para din po ma-highlight yung kagandahan natin. Char! Akin daw hesitate to occupy the stage din po, ating mga ladies. Yes. Yes, the ladies. And there's still a lot of space upstairs. Yeah? Okay. Medyo unstable na po. Ah, okay. So the others, if you want to bring the chairs para bukas siya or kung willing may willing lumuhod, ganyan, meron pa po tayo dito. Yes. Yeah, chairs na lang siguro po. Thank you.
Thank you.